Hiya. Recently, I did an artwork with a little bit of magic in it, and I thought I would show you my technique on how to make magic with like particles and stuff. Pretty simple in Photoshop if you just manipulate the brush settings a little bit. So I'll show you how I did it in case it comes in handy. If anyone's worried about knowing the size, it's about 2400 by 3600 pixels at 300 resolution. This kind of affects like when your brush size changes and stuff. It might be because I have a bigger document or so on than you. But anyways, to start with, we're gonna pick a darker color for the background. So the lighter it is, the less you can make your magic like glowy and stuff, because it won't show up against the contrast of the light on light. So get something a little bit dark down here to start with, and you can manipulate it later because we'll leave this on a separate layer. Make another layer, and I'm going to call this the magic base. What you can do now, maybe change your brush opacity to something like 50% and just put something in. I'm gonna make mine blue. Just put something in to represent the magic base that you want. I actually have something just I made with a pen tool to make mine a little bit crisper, but you are welcome to do it with your brush this way too. And if you're wondering about the pen tool, I put this shape in and I'm gonna fill it to 60% with a 4 pixel radius and get that there. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of make this a glowy little friend of ours. So I'm gonna make a new layer and call it Magic Base Glow. Right here by the layers, wherever you have your layers open, there's an option here to change the blending mode, and we're gonna go to color dodge right down here. Right now I have my opacity at 50%. I have my little airbrush thing clicked here too, if that helps. And we're just gonna use the same color for this. We'll add a little bit of a magic glow. We won't worry too much about this. So this is the first pass, and it kind of gives it a little bit of an aura. And the second pass, I'm going to focus more on the internal part. And the third pass, I'll focus a little bit more on the internal part. And then we can start making our color a little bit more. You can also turn your opacity down if you want to be a little bit more delicate with it, but we're just going to kind of get it going. Let's add a few more little glowies there. Next up, we'll make it even brighter. Add a few more little glowies there. And there. We have that kind of glowy look. Maybe I'll bring this up a little bit more. A few little radius spots. Whatever. Either way, you can make this a little bit more fancy if you want. One thing I'm going to show you how to do too. Take this magic base layer, and you can duplicate it either by right-clicking on it and says duplicate layer, or there's a command J that I like to do. And since our opacity was 50%, it's going to make it a little more glowy. But I'm actually going to take this copy layer, and I'm going to go up to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And well, I was already at like 60 pixels. Let's do like 45. Sure, that's good. And that'll give it even more of a glow. So now we have a little bit of a glowy magic light. You can play with this and build it a little bit more so it glows a little bit more. But we're gonna leave it for now. We'll just move on to the particles. So we're gonna make another layer. On tutorials, I usually just do everything on a new layer. But if you're crafty, you can combine layers if you need to. And we're gonna call this the top glow particles, or whatever you wanna call it. All right, I'm still on 50% for my opacity on my brush. And if I didn't say already, I'm using the default soft round pressure size brush. Just this default soft round one is what you need. And then I'm gonna go up to window. And I'm sorry that the window is cut off from the top, but it's the drop down menu window, and then these options come up. And there's one called brush settings, and we're gonna click this. And mine's gonna pop up over here. Yours might pop up separately depending on how your interface is set up. And then I'm going to take this and I'm gonna squish it a bit because I think the perfectly round look is a little bit sus. It just looks a little better to me, oblong, so I'm gonna do it. And then there's a setting here called spacing, and I'm just gonna crank it. You can adjust it how you want. I'm just gonna crank it all the way. And then you go down to size dynamics, and there's something called size jitter at the top of that. And we'll put that at like 50%, 58, 56, okay, that's fine. And then angle jitter, since I have an oblong, we can mess with this a bit. We'll put that at about 50%. And then one more setting down here, scattering. I'm gonna click that. It's gonna automatically click it on when I select it. And we'll put the scattering, it's like 338. Just between like 300 and 400 will be good. Now I am using my tablet, so my line variation will be more than yours. But if you want it more varied, you can go back up to this where it says size jitter and get more varied from that. And you can pick whatever, maybe you want to like a nice light color, pick the center of this. And I'm just gonna put a few of these over the top, give it kind of a few like glowy things. You don't want to like overcrowd it too much. I want one up there. You know, I don't care about fine-tuning this too much. And while we have this brush setting before we give it up, I'm going to click on this background layer and make one more for back glow particles. And I might make my brush just a little bit bigger. Right now, I guess I have it at 1000%. That was after adjusting it. I'm gonna make these back ones a little bit darker, and they're gonna sit behind everything, so they kind of look even more in the background. I'm just gonna put a few in, and you can change your size if you want a few smaller ones to go with it. Put them in like that. Okay, and then one more little finishing touch, and we're gonna make one more layer. This will be the last one on top. We're gonna call it Sharp Particles. We're gonna go, remember we had this soft round brush. We're gonna change the hardness to like, I don't know, 50 to 60. And then I'm gonna change my opacity up a little bit more to like 80-ish. And then I'm gonna pick this bright center color. And I'm gonna go back to the brush tip shape and make this even more compressed. And I'm gonna add a few little things like this. I've turned my size of my brush down, by the way. It's down at 100. A few little things like this. And they just kind of add like this, just to add a few little like cool particle things. And then I'm gonna change my opacity even more for just a few little top ones. I'm gonna change my hardness even more to like 77. And I'm gonna pick an even lighter color and just finish it off with a few that just stick out a little bit more. Maybe I'll even do a few that are just pure white. Okay, and then I want these sharp particles to look that way, but I also want them to look a little glowy. So we're gonna do that trick again where we duplicate this layer. It doesn't really matter as long as one's on top and one's on the other. And you can see because I wasn't full opacity, it makes it a little bit brighter. I'm gonna move this one to the bottom. It's just a preference, no big deal. And then I'm gonna go back to that filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And I'm gonna, I don't know, maybe it doesn't need, yeah, we'll keep it at like 27. That'll be a good one. And that's about it. So you can go around and you can mess with the settings. You can go back to like your color dodge layer. To reset your brush, you can just like move it off another one and move it back on again. And if you get one that you really like, you can save it with this little menu here. Of course, I've already turned off the settings. But yeah, that's about it. You can go in, do some little touch-ups, add any little ones that you want left. You could go around and like add a few more little glowy parts anywhere that you want. Like maybe you could add like a more bright core there. Whatever you want to do. Or you could add a few little spots here and here and here if you want to add like a little variation. The sky's the limit. Either way, I just wanted to show that kind of technique to make like little particles for your magic thing. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions. I hope you're having a good day. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video.